See here, I drifted way over onto the waste portion that time, so I'll clean that up with my sharp chisel. See here, but that's okay. I don't want to come back yet. I don't want to let it drift back the other way. That's what I don't want, where it's going to be into my finished workpiece on the exterior of the joint. Now I know I didn't cut far enough with the rip blade, so I'm going to probably need to waste a little bit more material before the pieces will break off. I don't want to cut down into my shoulder. Now I'm ready to just clean this up with a sharp chisel. Okay, I put this block behind here just so while I'm pressing on it with my chisel that I have a really good support and it doesn't rotate over on me. So now I just want to clean this shoulder up and then I should be done. So again, when my blade came in here, I'm exaggerating, but I was more in like this versus here. See, so now you can see that I didn't come back in and damage my crisp, clean edge where all these four corners meet so nicely. And so otherwise I would have had to remove even more material around to get it to look just right. So I'm just gonna do a little rough cleanup. This piece is just gonna get put in the chiminea anyway, so I mean it's not a real piece for any of my projects, but I just wanted to. And always two hands on the knife. That's why you always spend the time to clamp your workpiece instead of this. This is what you don't want to do, is try to hold your workpiece and do chisel work at the same time. My chisels are too sharp for that. They would go right through your whatever body part. I got it. I got just a little bit of chisel work to do to get this guy cleaned up a little bit more. Good sharp chisel is just the ticket for cutting this end grain off cleanly. That's not bad. I mean, that's Mitutoyo square right there. And you're not going to get much squarer than that. So here you got a nice clean shoulder. And so that was just done, you know, fairly quickly with hand tools. And this doesn't really need to be that cleaned up, because this is where glue is probably going to be anyway. And you want a good rough surface for the glue to grab onto. Okay, so I wanted to just show you by doing this little demonstration of Japanese saws. I just wanted to show you how easy it is that in a pinch, if your saw is occupied with another setup, or to be able to even if it's not, even be able to just do the setup on a table saw again, that it, in a pinch, or if you're on the job site, that you can create a tenon very, very quickly and very accurately, just with some simple hand tools, namely the Japanese saws and a square and a chisel. And you know, if you're in the middle of nowhere and you realize that you forgot one piece, well, here's a way that you can come up with the piece that you're short really, really quickly. And I think this shows you that not only this type of joinery, but a lot of other joinery and cuts can be made with Japanese saws very, very accurately.